More than 6,000 people have been detained since the coup, and journalists, both local and foreign, are one of the many groups being targeted. 3 months ago, I was forced to leave Myanmar, the place I had called home for almost a decade. After a military coup on February 1, a little crackdown on protest and widespread arrest had made it impossible to safely continue working as a journalist there. I drove to the airport in the early morning. The streets were quiet, but signs of that had taken place hours earlier were everywhere. Brick dust stained the streets red, while concrete blocks and large orange rubbish bins were scattered across the roads, left over from the makeshift barricades protesters used in a hopeless attempt to protect themselves from the onslaught of security forces and their bloods. The walls and overpasses were littered with the graffiti, three-finger salutes and profanities commended the coup and the military leaders. It was an emotional journey. I was leaving friends and loved ones behind to face a situation that only seemed to be getting worse as I flew back to the comfort and safety of the United Kingdom.
अगर अभी तक आप लोगों ने हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब नहीं किया है तो सबसे पहले इसे सब्सक्राइब कर ले, साथ में रेड कलर के बेल आइकन को दबाएं, जिससे कि रोजाना देश विदेश की खबरें आप तक पहले पहुंच सके। साथ में आप अपने सुझाव को हमारे कमेंट बॉक्स में भी लिख सकते हैं और इसे ज्यादा से ज्यादा शेयर करें।